Hi, my name is Dan Mascola, the founder of Moosiko, and there has been a lot of discussion lately about the cleaning of instruments in the classroom, and so I got a little curious and I want to run a little experiment. Now, I'm not a medical expert and I'm not an epidemiologist, so when referring to cleaning your instruments for the classroom in the upcoming school year, please refer to the CDC guidelines and the NAFME report that came out recently. I'll leave the links in the description. Okay, now let's have some fun. I got some of this glow germ gel, which simulates the spreading of germs and transmission of germs from your hands to other objects or other people. And it's really cool because it shines very brightly under UV light. And we have an ultraviolet flashlight here so we can see how it gets transmitted. So here's what we're going to do. I'm going to use a little bit of this gel to rub on my hands to simulate germs being stuck on my hands. Then we're going to play the guitar and see what happens. Under the UV light, you can see I've got pretty good coverage on the front and back of my hands, even around the fingernails. So here's what we're going to do. I'm going to play a song called Counting Stars by One Republic. It's got your basic four chords in it, and it has an F chord so I can simulate what a bar chord would look like.
Praying hard, said no more counting dollars, we'll be counting stars. Yeah, we'll be counting stars. I see this life like a swinging vine, swing my heart across the line.
Let's bring out that UV light and take a look. So you can definitely see at the top of the neck on the fretboard, there's some transmission from where I was playing chords and also on the strings. There's also a little bit on the back of the neck near the body where I was kind of holding and maneuvering the guitar, but not too much up the neck where my fret hand was on the back of the neck there. Most of it was really on the front and on the strings. Now looking at the body, we couldn't really see any germ transmission there. I mean, I didn't touch the body, and of course while playing, you're not really touching the body. On the sides and the back of the guitar, again, there wasn't much transmission that we could see. Most of it was up around where I was fretting those four chords for the song. Now, taking a look at the pick, it was pretty covered on both sides, obviously, and then my hands were pretty well covered as well. So the next thing we wanted to do is go and try to see if we could actually clean the guitar. And what I did is I used a rag with some warm soapy water on it, and I also had another rag to dry. If you're worried about kind of ruining the finish of your guitar, definitely check with the guitar manufacturer and they can recommend the proper way to kind of clean the guitar without ruining any of the external finishes. If you have a vintage guitar or something that's more expensive, you definitely want to go that route. My kind of beginner Yamaha, I've had it for a decade. A little warm soap and water on the top isn't going to hurt it. And if your guitars are, you know, beginner guitars for your students, I think you'll be okay.
But before I could go and clean the guitar, I needed to wash my hands to get all of the germs off. I did this for the recommended 20 seconds. I actually sang happy birthday, which you could do as well. All right, time to give this guitar a good scrub down. So I used a microfiber towel that I soaked with warm water and a little bit of soap, and basically cleaned the one face of the guitar and then dried it off with the blue rag, just so I wasn't letting water or soap kind of sit on that exterior finish for too long. Once I gave the guitar a good wipe down, let's see how we did. So back under the UV light, you can see that we actually missed the spot right behind the third fret. The germs and the kind of glow gel really get in there between the strings and can kind of hide themselves behind the fret. So I just wiped it off. Then we inspected the body of the guitar, and we didn't notice any germ transmission there. We also looked at the back of the body and the back of the neck, and we did a pretty good job cleaning. So my first attempt at actually cleaning the guitar failed because I missed the spot and left some germs on the neck of the guitar. You'll be able to see that when I was kind of cleaning an up and down motion on the full part of the six strings and on the neck of the guitar. And I was determined to do this again and see if I could create a better cleaning methodology that actually got more of the germs off the guitar. And so I actually ran the whole experiment again, same song, same length of time, and then we tried a new cleaning methodology. So this is what the guitar looked like after the second attempt, and you can see a similar type of residue pattern on the first three frets on the neck of the guitar. So this time, instead of kind of wiping the entire neck all at once, I really focused on getting in between each individual string and cleaning the front of the neck. Really making sure that I clean before and after each fret to get the spot that I missed last time. Then I gave it a quick dry. Now let's take a look. You can see this time the neck looks very clean. No indication of the glow germ at all. So I was really happy with the results after our second attempt and the new cleaning methodology. Here is the photo showing before cleaning and after cleaning. This was a really fun experiment, and this glow germ stuff is really, really cool. It's 40 or 50 bucks on Amazon with the ultraviolet flashlight. You could even get some to have in your class with the kids. They can play around with it and kind of learn about transmitting germs as well as playing guitar. So no matter what next semester holds, whether it's in person or remote, I hope you and your students have a great and fun time and stay safe. Bye, guys.